Ta-da! Quantum of Solace. 007 difficulty. Rebel Link walkthroughs. For nextgenwalkthroughs.com. Casino Royale. So, almost to the end. We got this level. Got, wait, don't tell me. The barge. We got Venice, I think, right? Yeah, Venice. And then we got Echo Hotel, and we're all done. Done with this biatch. And then we'll move on to whatever other game endeavor I'm going to do. I think at this time it's going to be Wanted. I have a Gamefly. And for those who don't, y'all should really look into getting that, because that's really the answer to all gamers' prayers, because if you don't know what it is, it's like Netflix, basically. And you pay a monthly fee. If you just want one game, $15. Two games, $22, I think. And play as long as you want. And it's just really awesome, because otherwise, go to the old method and buy games, trade them in, hope we like them. And, yeah, I'd rather not do that. Like this way, much better. However, it does suck, kind of, for developers and people who... I'm not sure how the Gamefly model works, but, you know, we're getting to enjoy these games while not actually buying them. And the developers, publishers, etc., game makers, obviously the revenue depends on you buying the game, but maybe Gamefly has a deal worked out to where it's worth it, because it is worth it to me. Otherwise, I can't imagine me spending $60 on this game. I would spend $60 on Fallout game, Call of Duty series, Halo, you know, BioShock. Those are the games you spend, at least in my opinion, $60 on. And you know, just worth it, because the replay value is just ridiculous. This one, I didn't get all the achievements, but you know, that's probably the only other thing that you could really do with this game. Try to go for that 1,000 gamer score. But I did it. Have a lot of other things to do. So, we're in the pool, and this place here, if you get a chance to, and you have a really good television, 1080p, or even better, 120 refresh, 1080p, for those who know what I'm talking about, you know what I'm talking about. For those who don't, I feel sorry for you, man. But, you know, if you're at your local Best Buy or something, ask to see, something on 120 refresh. Mind-blowing. So, alright, so strategy here is, you see that I kind of took out a couple people, ran automatically to the left into this cover here, and you're going to have, I think, just two waves, and then you have a couple guys down at the far end you want to be wary of, so be on the lookout. And usually if you stay here, for whatever reason, at least the times that I played through it, the enemies you would think would kind of rush you here, you know, pop around this corner right here and just try and take you out, but not so, and they didn't do it to me, so I don't think they'd be it to you. But, oh yeah, yeah, so if you got all those things, this room, once you clear out the enemies, if you really take a look at the texture and just a little layout. Man, this room looks really sharp. Even the water. I'm hard to impress with water, but that's some damn good looking water. So mad props to Treyarch for that. So those are the other guys I was talking about. So you hear those voices? Like right now I'm trying to figure out where the heck they are. What I don't know, I'm gonna find out here soon. They're tucked away in the left corner room. Similar to this, what I'm in right now. But a little bit that the room up there to the left. And I don't know it, but I'm about to find out here soon. Lucky I didn't die. Probably because I was mining the water. But now they're behind me. And now I know where they're at. So, if you're in the same scenario where those same guys are in there, toss frag in there, take a cover, and then take them out. That's probably the best way to go about that. Then sometimes there's that one guy in there, but I already took him out, so it's all good. And this part's pretty funny. Some interesting game AI here in a second. I take out this guy, right? I watch the other guy. He's gonna look at me. And I freak out. I'm like, oh god. I took him out real quick. I think the first time I played it too, I headshotted both of them. So, but either way, you take them out. As long as they don't shoot or fire off their weapons, then you're okay. You don't have to worry about them setting off the alarm. So. And then you have one guard in this room, one guard in the hallway, and then one of your guys is going to chime in about Le Chief, the guy you're following or whatever. And then that's going to be the end of this part one. So, pretty easy. Just follow the rest of this tutorial and we'll see you in part two.
Change in plan. Le Chief never made it to Obono's room.
I know. He's in the ballroom.
Where are they? Le Chief's men.
We have seen no one.
They killed a dozen of our soldiers in the spa.
We will take Le Chief to my room. The rest of you stay here. We must hold this place.